And we're back.
And I got the thing. There we go.
Now we're back.
Shadow was missing an arm there for a second.
It's only a flesh wound. Oh. End of the line.
How come his looks cooler?
Sorry, you gay.
I'm glad they all died in one hit.
That car was pretty OP, man.
So just fuck off then.
I guess get memed. You know, at some point you gotta go fight that,
Oh. Okay,
that one UFO robot.
I wanna fight a UFO robot.
End of the line! You maybe, you might not be able to now, actually.
Sorry.
If you're already in the Magitek robots.
Nope, and that just blocks it off. Looks like nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
Oh no, solitors.
Just cue a bunch of fire beams. I don't care anymore.
Yeah, beam.
I wonder if you can multicast Firebeam. Probably not, but let's try.
No, I don't think you can multicast with the event. Almost. We did it. Yeah.
Notice I'm not getting experience for these.
Yeah, there's the UFO man.
Wanna fight him. Boom.
Pew! Buster Beam! That's something you and I need to watch, is Gunbuster together. That's on the list.
It is on the list. It's pretty deep on the list, though.
Yeah, but it's also, like, the shortest thing that's probably on the list.
Granted.
So we could probably just expedite it up. Yeah, it's not gonna let you fight it. Damn.
I
wanna maybe
fight it.
Back later once you ditch the armor.
Alright, what about down here? I mean, that tree is in the way. Yep. I'm glad everything that I attempt is doomed to die.
If only you had some kind of large robotic apparatus with which you could uproot the tree.
Yeah, too bad we don't got one of those.
Maybe if it had fire-based laser beams, that'd also help.
Oh, okay. Ah, she ain't. Horse to the south. Glad Shadow's still with us.
Yeah, he's just hanging out. Once you get on the ghost train, he won't leave, so that's fortunate.
Good. Grasshoppers.
Oh no, you only made him useful. Yeah, the anger status only really bothers mages who don't have a lot of attack power. Because it also makes you hit harder.
Dude. I remember making your dudes angry in Final Fantasy VII was really useful, especially if you have really good attack limit breaks.
Yeah. Well, there's not too many just direct Maguses in Final Fantasy VII, to my knowledge.
Not really. You got Aerith, you got Red 13.
Is he a mage?
I want to say. Like, he's more magic than not magic, I think. but he still has some attack. Cate Sith.
Yeah, there's Cate Sith.
Yeah, don't even. I know I'm pronouncing it wrong, and at this point, it's out of fucking spite.
And then there's the fucking Edgelord McDouchenpants.
Vincent?
Yeah.
This is off limits. Well, okay. You heard him, boys. Off limits. Back it up.
Man, if only we were some kind of rebellion force.
If only we were some sort of, like, ragtag team of misfits who could shoot lasers out of their goddamn hands.
We need to find someone like that. So I know you gotta go through that forest over there.
Yeah.
The ghost holds. Go back to the base and see if you can get back in and fight that thing.
Alright. I will try. Everyone's out in full force with their hogs today.
Yeah, the weather's good for it.
Actually, it's not good for it today, because we had a major thunderstorm.
You think that's going to stop Motorcycle Man?
Granted.
He eats thunder and craps lightning.
I believe it.
He's the hero of men. The slayer of gods.
Oh, that camp's just gone. Oh, wait, no, it's up there. I was going to say, I thought it was in front of a bridge.
We wiped out the entire desert.
This is kind of fun. Oh, no!
Oh, yeah, these are a good thing to actually fight, because I was telling you about this, but these guys have the strongest physical attack move in the game, and Gao can use it.
Okay, so good to know.
So it's very fortuitous that we encountered them.
They're going to tell them that... I'll go. Work. They're going to tell me to steal from them or something.
Nope, just need to encounter them.
All right.
The fortunate thing is, once we have the airship, we can pretty much explore this entire world. Nope, can't. Alright, darn.
That sucks. Oh no! Bug on side.
See, I keep playing this game thing. It's like, man, I gotta do it, all the cool stuff, because I play with guides in these kind of games, because I am a fucking optimal piece of shit. No, you gotta do it right. Gotta do it all.
I will. No, I'm lying. I actually won't.
Oh, no. You need to complete the entire game. 100%. That means maxing out magic on every single character and getting every single encounter so that you get all of Gao's rages.
There is only one... There's a handful of games where I'm down with 100% of them. As most because they make it easy to 100% them. One of them is Earthbound, and then also one of them is not Earthbound. Because I'll 100% Earthbound, but I won't get the Sword of Kings. Because fuck that.
Why not?
Because Sword of Kings is one of the most infamous items to grind for in that game. Because it's only dropped in one area by a single enemy, and the drop rate is 1 in 128.
Mm.
And once you leave that area of the game, you can never come back and you never fight that enemy again.
How wonderful.
The Phantom Forest.
Ghost.
And a Poplium.
Final Fantasy VII and the fucking ghost. I disgraced myself. Final Fantasy VI and the fucking ghost.
You got it, sport.
This is where I did most of my early Magicite grinding before I got the airship and was able to go to Triangle Island.
Is it an island shaped like a triangle?
Yes.
Alright.
And I grinded here because if you encounter a single ghost, they give 3 Magicite points. Which is a fairly significant amount at this stage of the game. But the mini boss who spawns on Triangle Island gives 10. Which is the highest amount in the game. But it's also invisible, so physical attacks don't work on it. It absorbs every magic element. And if it's ever damaged at all, or if it receives an attack, it just casts Meteo, the strongest spell in the game. But the way you beat it is you just cast a death spell on it, because Final Fantasy VI in most versions of the game is glitched, and death will hit it if it's invisible every time.
That's great.
And if it does, it doesn't get a chance to counterattack with Meteo.
That's good. Am I supposed to be following those signs?
Go straight up. Yeah, there we go.
Okay.
I don't remember the total layout of this place yet.
Oh, there's a ghost train.
Scooby-Doo and the fucking ghost train.
That sounds like a thing.
And it probably is. I remember there was one Scooby-Doo special that was Halloween-based, and they went to fucking Halloween Fairyland. And they got by riding on a ghost train. You think I'm joking.
No, I don't think you are.
Oh, was Scooby-Doo and the Goblin King.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. I saw that, like, on the TV schedule back when I had cable, and then I never bothered to watch it.
You didn't miss much.
I bet I didn't. There are very few Scooby-Doo movies that are worth my time.
Mostly just the earlier ones that are worth watching.
Yeah, it's Zombie Island, the Alien one, and the one before that.
I usually, Boo Brothers.
Boo Brothers is good. Okay, the Shaggy specials are good.
Yeah.
Like, playing the
simple. I think the only really kind of passable, the only Scooby-Doo early movie that I would just absolutely pass on is the one where Scooby-Doo is turned into a werewolf, and yeah, and they have the wacky races. Why? I don't fucking know.
Yeah.
I don't understand what the point of that
is. I think I've seen that one exactly once.
I've seen it a few times, mostly because there'd be nothing on TV except that fucking movie.
Yeah, no, it's okay, all the Shaggy specials are gold.
Except that one.
Zombie Island is great.
Zombie Island is fantastic. A lot of people like the Alien one. I'm not super.
I could see why people wouldn't like it, but I do happen to like it.
Yeah. Can we both agree that Cyber Chase is awful?
It has some good points and bad points. I will agree. I'm trying to remember. There was a third movie. Oh, Scooby-Doo and the Witch's Ghost.
Yeah. Witch's Ghost is pretty. That was fantastic.
Yeah.
It's got the Hex Girls, man.
I mean,
Big titty goth GFs.
I know, right? But,
three.
Yeah. But yeah, no, like, that was the third one I was trying to remember.
Yeah, which goes really good.
Yeah.
I think my all-time general favorite Scooby-Doo movie is still probably Boo Brothers.
Boo Brothers is good. I think my all-time favorite is still going to be, Zombie Island. It's just that good.
It's just really well made. I'm trying to think if they were the What's New Scooby-Doo age, or if they were in like a weird transition between the old cartoon.
I think they were in a weird transition period. And I think, to my knowledge, that was like the first time in the movies, because I believe they pulled this like almost every other movie afterwards. But that was the first time where they pulled the card of like, oh wait, actually this is real.
Yeah. That's kind of why I get a kick out of Boo Brothers, is because it's still like, hey, there's actually like a mystery and it's the guy in a costume, but also there's just fucking ghosts. They're just here.
Oh, someone died.
The witch's ghost is also kind of in that same camp.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, Demi.
Because it's still a guy in a costume, but he's also like trying to be more than a guy in a costume.
Okay, come on.
Now, are you of the same camp that if Tim Curry is in a movie, you don't remember the actual character's name, they're just Tim Curry?
Because
I don't know what that fucking asshole's name was in Witch's Ghost.
I'm trying to remember most of it. I'm trying to remember most because I haven't seen that movie in a long time.
Yeah, he was the main villain.
I know. I'm just saying, like, I haven't seen that movie in a long time.
And, I know he had a stupid fantasy, like, witch name. Because that's the plot, is that he's the descendant of the stupid witch.
He's the descendant of the stupid witch.
Scooby-Doo and the stupid witch.
Like, orc.
All right, while we're talking about obscure Scooby-Doo, can we talk about the multiple crossovers with the Harlem Globetrotters?
Dude, I will hear no naysaying. I will have no ill being spoken of the Harlem Globetrotters in any media they happen to worm their way in.
Yeah, I remember there was like a period. It was before What's New Scooby-Doo.
Yeah.
But it was distinctly after the original run.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it was still in the same style, but it was like its own thing. And the gimmick was that almost every episode had a guest character.
Yeah, 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 because that was a specific series. And one of my favorite ones was anytime fucking Don Knotts showed up. I don't know why, but I liked it.
The ones that always come to mind for me is the fucking Harlem Globetrotters. They had like 4 episodes.
Yeah, no, it's good. I don't know why, but it's good. It checks out. Oh, I need to look that up after this, because I need to remember what episodes Don Knotts showed up in. But also, I think, led to one of the better Just Anthony things of Don Knotts is more of a person than John Cena.
Yep, there's Don Knotts on Scoobypedia. Is a police officer in the town of Juneberry.
Yep.
Physical appearances. Insert details here. Personality. Insert details here. I wish someone would go into this this obscure wiki and just under personality put Don Knotts.
Appearances, Don Knotts. Gender, Don Knotts. Height, Don Knotts.
Gender, Don Knotts. Species, Don Knotts. There's a species category! Yeah, he had 2. In the Scooby-Doo movies, he was in 105. Guess who's not coming to dinner? Of Juneberry.
Also, we have just a ghost friend.
Yeah. I almost forgot about the ghost friend. He's a character, I think.
Can we talk about the fucking sprite work on this train?
Yeah, no. It's really good. I really enjoy the ghost train segment.
Bork.
Bork. Yeah, it was called the... It was called the New Scooby-Doo Movies, or sometimes called the New Scooby-Doo Comedy Movies.
Yeah.
And that ran... Was... It ran from 72 through
73. That was a weird time.
What a magical era. Frank Welker, as literally everyone. If there's a random character or animal noise in your cartoon, it's probably Frank Welker.
Yep.
That man's fucking IMDb page is an encyclopedia / phone book. Guest cast. The voices of the Three Stooges, Laurel and Hardy, are provided by voice actors. Okay, no. Not the actual comedian. I was gonna say, didn't Three Stooges were already kind of gone by then?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they were like
they were either dead or pretty old. Cause they weren't young guys when they were at the height of their popularity, which was flipping forever ago.
I think
back in mythical olden times.
The olden days before everything became color.
Laurel and Hardy were both deceased. Okay.
Yep.
Oh, they were on hiatus because Larry had suffered a stroke, which impaired his speech. So they were still alive.
Okay.
That's interesting. Wednesday is Missing features the Addams Family television cast.
Wonderful.
What? I remember that episode.
I don't think I do.
It wasn't anything spectacular.
I would imagine.
Oh, the Addams Family is here. Got it. I get the crossover. Thank you.
I understand the joke.
The Harlem Globetrotters.
Once again, saving the day.
Apparently there was a Harlem Globetrotters animated series. Good to know.
Yes, there was.
They were also the most frequent guest stars on the new Scooby-Doo movies, appearing 3 times in the series. The only other guest stars to appear more than once were Don Knotts, Batman and Robin, and the Three Stooges, who all appeared twice.
Yep.
What a magical time. I forgot Batman and Robin crossed over.
I actually distinctly remember that episode.
Apparently there was 2.
I remember one of them. Oh, God. Is my memory trying to hype me up or what? Because I almost want to say that Don Knotts and Batman appeared in a single episode.
Well, now we gotta find out.
Oh, memory, don't fail me. Because that sounds cool.
He appeared in a few. He appeared in Guess Who's Not Coming to Dinner. Actually, there's an easier way of doing this.
Yes.
You can see, compare Don Knotts's to Batman's. No, they were in separate ones.
Darn. Oh, memory, you did me dirty.
Batman's appearances were in The Dynamic Scooby-Doo Affair and The Caped Crusader Caper.
Right, back when they thought that shit was cute. Hey, who am I kidding? They still think it's cute.
Yes. For the episodes in which they appeared, Davy Jones and Jerry Reed both performed songs originally recorded as chase songs for the second season of Scooby-Doo Where Are You?
Right.
In The Haunted Horseman of Hagglethorne Hall, Jones performs I Can Make You Happy, originally from the Scooby-Doo Where Are You episode Mystery Mask Mix-Up. In the Phantom of the Country Music Hall. What a name. Reed repeatedly performs Pretty Mary Sunlit, originally from the Scooby-Doo Where Are You episode Don't Fool with the Phantom.
Wonderful.
Batman and Robin were voiced by Olan Sewell and Casey Kasem, respectively, both reprising their roles from the Filmation produced The Adventures of Batman. Mm-hmm. This seems like a good time as any to jump off this subject and change the subject from Scooby-Doo. Favorite Batman?
Favorite Batman? Probably Batman Animated.
Okay, I'm glad we continue to be the same person.
Like, that's just the definitive Batman to me. Just not only because it has Mark Hamill as Joker, but also because... oh, God, I always forget his name. It's the dude who does Batman.
Oh, I'd normally know it, but now I'm on the spot and we're being recorded. Girls are watching. Now I won't be able to remember.
Yep.
Fuck.
I spread my curse.
What the hell is it? I'm gonna have to look it up. God damn it.
I did it. I am, in fact, Batman.
I'm gonna be really mad when I find it. Kevin Conroy.
Yeah, Conroy. Okay.
I was mad. I was right.
Yeah, no, fucking Kevin Conroy is Batman. Like, that's just Batman to me.
Yeah. Well, I think because the animated Bat one is Batman is one of the few Batman who is inherently flavored.
Yeah.
Because like there's the Dark Knight Batman.
Yeah.
But he's the Dark Knight Batman. He's like, you don't think, oh, this is Batman. No, he's the Dark Knight Batman. Or even the earlier movie Batmans. Or there's Adam West Batman. Whereas the animated Batman is just fucking Batman.
Yeah.
Just Batman. Which reminds me, we need to put the animated Batman on the list.
I almost want to say it is. I don't know where the list is right now. Oh, it's over there. It's behind my remote.
The animated Batman is fantastic.
Yes, it was. It's the animated list.
It also had an obscure list of, it also had an obscure list of movies.
Yes, it did. No, it's not on the list. I'll add it later.
Sounds good.
Okay, so it appears we are stuck in this car. This is the shopkeep.
There must be a side path somewhere. I think you have to go outside around one of the cars.
Get me out of here. I don't care.
Yeah, don't do this. No, escape!
Ghost! I like how we still got the drop on him.
Just spun him around and pantsed him.
He fucking led.
Now how will I get a date for Ghost Prom?
Okay, Ghost Prom on a ghost train? That sounds... God, they're fucking school shelled out.
I know, right? Ghost school doesn't fuck around.
Ghoul school.
Ghoul School.
Now there's a movie!
How did we forget about Ghoul School?
I don't think I did, I just failed to bring it up. Because I was thinking of Ghoul School during that entire, maybe that was the third one, and not Witch's Ghost, but Witch's Ghost still deserves to be on that list.
Like, yeah.
Okay, so there's a fourth one. Oh, right, because I gave the blanket, all Shaggy movies are great.
Yeah, that's fair.
Because it is a Shaggy movie.
It's a Shaggy movie.
Okay.
I'm trying to remember the other Shaggy movies, because there's Boo Brothers, there's Ghoul School, there's a fucking werewolf, just terrible.
The one we won't talk about.
I'm trying to remember the other ones. I'm being called, so didn't vamp without me.
Oh no! I'm on my own! Alright, well then I guess it's just... Yep, nope, we're gonna make it. We're gonna be jumping, aren't we? Come, Zaya! We did it. We double did it. Those bastards are fast. See ya, bitch. Okay, but how do I actually get to the other side? Oh. That switch is pulling double duty. Okay. Shuriken to the Skeleton Man. We're not doing this today. Yeah, that's what I thought. Next episode is Bolo's Train.